My name is Gabriella Conti, and I'm an assistant professor of economics at the Harris School of Public Policy at the University of Chicago. My research aims at understanding the developmental origins of health inequalities. So I study when health inequalities emerge early in life, how they are transmitted from the cell to the life cycle, and what can we do about them and when. Why health disparities exist is a very big and complicated question. Now, in joint work that I've done with Nobel Prize winner James Heckman, we have looked at this very question in a completely new and different perspective. We have been thinking, what if there are other factors early in the life cycle developmental process, factors such as family environment, early childhood development, which affect later health? You can explain a good part of the disparities later in life just by looking at what happens in the early life of the child. So the best causal evidence that we have comes from the Romanian orphanages. Here, children were raised in less than optimal conditions. And it has been shown repeatedly throughout the years that these conditions have led to suboptimal development, the presence of behavioral problems of these children, and also less than optimal growth. So what can we do in order to understand better the importance of early family environments, parenting, and the presence of a parent by itself? We cannot answer these questions with humans, but I was lucky enough to collaborate with Steve Swamy at the National Institute of Health Animal Center, and to use data from his experiment on rhesus monkeys. What happens there? We can actually do something that is not possible with humans. We can take children away from their mothers soon after birth to see what is so important and basic and biological about the presence of a mother and what is the very meaning of attachment for the child.
We have three basic rearing conditions. One is monkeys growing up with their biological mother in small groups with other females and their infants.
We can think of the mother-reared monkeys as the normal environment in which children are raised with their mothers.
We have a second condition that's called peer-only rearing. Here the monkeys are raised, hand-reared in the neonatal nursery for the first month or so of life, and then they're put into small peer groups, four or five individuals, where they stay with one another until they're 6 or 7 months of age.
And so we can think, for example, of the children raised in the orphanages where they're raised with their peers, but with absence of one main caregiver to which they established a strong attachment relationship.
The third condition is what we call surrogate peer rearing. Here the monkeys, after their initial month of life, are growing up with an artificial mother that is inanimate, it's a dummy.
You can think of these as the cases in which the children are abused, they are neglected, they do not develop strong, secure attachment relationship with a caregiver that we know is really at the basis of the healthy child development. What we found when we looked at this data is something absolutely striking. Surrogate-reared male monkeys were 5 times as likely as those reared with their mothers to show the presence of abnormal behavior. The peer-reared male ones were 3 times as likely. You can see that just by looking at them, it is very clear which monkeys have been raised under what conditions. You can see that there is a group of monkeys which still cling to each other, and those are the peer-reared monkeys. Then you see that there are some other monkeys who are actually there on their own. And those are the monkeys who actually have been raised for the first 6 months of their life on their own, alone in a cage with a surrogate mother. Their outcomes, whether they are on a causal chain. If they are on a causal chain, that's really important because if the biological mechanisms are the same across the two species, then we can learn something about the humans. When we looked at the physical health of these monkeys, we found differences. In particular, the male monkeys raised with the surrogate presented a much higher probability to get sick, and also to get sick more often than the one raised by the mothers. And what the types of diseases these monkeys were affected by were those clearly related to stress conditions. We took blood from a small sample of 13 monkeys from the leukocytes, which are the cells which regulates our immune defense, how our body reacts to adverse agents. From these cells, we extracted the RNA of the monkeys. So in this way, we wanted to understand whether the environment gets under the skin and changes the way our body works. The downregulated genes are actually those related to antiviral response. So the body reacts less to viruses. So these monkeys, not raised by the mothers, their whole immune system were basically working less than under normal conditions, which means that if attacked by viruses, these monkeys might not have been as effective in combating them, in defending from them, as the other monkeys. Now, this is the first time that we can provide causal evidence that actually the environment by itself can causally affect the biology of your body. What we're studying now is how persistent are these effects. This is very important because it might tell us that if the brain might have forgotten late in life what happened in your past, your body might still remember. And so if we know this, then we can act before we see the emergence of disease. We can act before disease occurs later in life. We can detect it in the body and we can intervene and prevent the damage before it occurs.